what's up, everybody? True Boxing here. Thank you for coming back to Get Hit with the Truth. Nighttime driving again. On my way home from work and my son's game. So just want to do the what's next for the undefeated and newly unified super bantamweight world champion, Stephen Fulton Jr., following his impressive 12-round majority decision victory over previously undefeated Brandon Figueroa. That was a really good unification bout that they had on Saturday, November 27th. Stephen Fulton really did all he could. He landed the cleaner, harder shots, caught Brandon Figueroa coming in a lot. Couldn't keep Figueroa off of him, but he just kept landing big shots, you know. And, you know, if he had a little bit more power, maybe he would hurt the bigger Figueroa, but be that as it may, he fought his ass off and fought hard and was impressive and scored a hard fought and some, you know, it was close. I'm not going to say it was a convincing decision. I'm saying it was a close fight. You know, Figueroa landed the harder, Fulton landed the harder shots, the more crisp shots, but Figueroa landed more and threw more. But it was, you know, your definition of who did the better and the more effective aggressiveness. His counter-punching ability on the inside, angle fighting that Stephen Fulton did, or Brandon Figueroa's just relentless, overwhelming throwing a shitload of punches. You know, it's just really what is, you know, the pick of your poison. But Fulton got the win. Figueroa was unhappy, called it a robbery, but Fulton said, hey, let's rematch then, and we leave no doubt. And it looks like Brandon Figueroa doesn't want to do that. He wants to move up to featherweight now, because that's what he was talking before the fight. He mentioned it after the fight too as a possibility and a likelihood, but we'll see. So let's run Stephen Fulton through the top 10 real quick and see what could possibly be next for the newly unified champion. Now we start with Fulton. To me, has moved up slightly past Mirajan Akhmadaliyev for the number one position right now at super bantamweight. Number two now is Mirajan Akhmadaliyev, the undefeated and other unified champion. He holds the WBA and IBF belt. And I'll tell you right now, an undisputed title fight is possible next for Stephen Fulton. He said he wanted to do it. Akhmadaliyev said he wanted to do it. Right now, the only thing that would hold, there's two things that might hold it up. Them being promoted by different people. Mirajan is with Eddie Hearn and Matchroom. And Stephen Fulton is with the PBC and Al Haymon. Now, they both expressed interest. I don't think it's impossible for these two sides to work together. So I really do think that these two promotions can work together to possibly make this fight. So I do believe we could see this fight take place. The other thing that's going to hold it up is if there's any mandatories due. As far as I know, Akhmadaliyev cleared up his IBF mandatory when he defeated Ryosuke Iwasa. I haven't heard of any new mandatories. I think they're doing a final eliminator for the IBF title, so I think that one's good. The WBA now, they are in the process of ordering Azat Havanasyan to fight, but I think they would be willing to allow an eliminator if an undisputed title fight became possible, and I think it is. So I don't think they're in a rush to mandate Havanasyan to fight Akhmadaliyev next, but they could. That's the point, is they could. What I think they should do is let Havanasyan fight Ronnie Rios in a rematch to determine a true number one contender for the WBA, and then the winner fights for the title in the second half of the year. That's my opinion, but we'll see. But for Stephen Fulton's side, his number one contender is the same for both his belts. The WBC and the WBO number one contender is former unified champion Daniel Roman. He's with the PBC, so that might hold things up, but we don't know as of yet. I haven't heard anything about mandatories holding things up for Stephen Fulton or Akhmadaliyev yet. So I absolutely think an undisputed title fight, that step-aside money can be paid if possible, and the governing bodies are willing to work out deals in order to make that fight happen. So I do think it's possible, and I hope it does happen, because that's huge for boxing to declare undisputed champions, because you get superstars, win or lose, in those kind of fights. You get the best fighting the best, and that's how stars are made right there. And both these fighters are undefeated champions. So I really hope that that is the fight that is possible, and or that possibly could happen next. Now, Brandon Figueroa has dropped down to number 3. A rematch is possible if Figueroa wants it. I think Fulton's down to do a rematch, but what does that do for Undisputed? But still, I do think it is possible. It is an option if Brandon Figueroa wants to fight. I think Stephen Fulton would accommodate him if Figueroa wants to fight. So we'll see. Number 4 now is Daniel Roman, the former Unified Champion. And as I said, he is the number 1 contender right now in both the WBC and the WBO. If Figueroa passes and Akhmadaliyev either gets a mandatory or they can't work out a deal, I think this is Fulton's next opponent, is Daniel Roman. He's the former Unified Champ. It would really, the way he performs against Roman would absolutely, if he performs better than Akhmadaliyev did, it would give him the leg up on Akhmadaliyev for the number 1 spot. So I absolutely think that Daniel Roman is a real possibility. Number 5 is Azat Havanasyan, the former world title challenger. I don't see him being possible for Stephen Fulton next. He fights for Golden Boy, and Golden Boy and the PBC working together is almost an impossibility, and he's not a mandatory challenger right now for either one of Fulton's titles, so I don't see it. Luis Neri is at number 6 right now. I believe it's the former champion. You know, he got knocked out against Brandon Figueroa, so as of right now, I think that's a step back for Stephen Fulton, but you can't rule it out completely because Neri is with the PBC, but he hasn't even returned yet since beating or since losing that fight to Figueroa, so I'm really not seeing that one happening as an option. Number 7 is Michael Conlan, the undefeated contender. I don't see it because Conlan is in line for a featherweight title. They're just finalizing the deal, and then I'm dropping him out of the rankings here at 122. Plus, he's with Top Rank, and Fulton is with PBC, so I'm not seeing it. Number 8 is Ronnie Rios. Rios fights with Golden Boy or Matchroom, one of those two, works with them, and DAZN, and he's kind of lined up in the WBA right now to get a shot at Akhmadaliyev next or possibly have to fight in an eliminator. So I don't see those two sides working together and him being a possibility for Stephen Fulton. Number 9 is Ionut Baluta, the contender. Really don't see this. It's kind of a high-risk, low-reward fight for Fulton. Baluta has lost to Michael Conlan earlier this year in a very close fight. And I just don't see Fulton. He's got too many other options. I don't see him given an opportunity here. And then the last 3, you got TJ Dohany, Ryosuke Iwasa, and Angelo Leo, all kind of tied at the back of the top 10 right there. Dohany's coming off a loss to Michael Conlan. I don't see that one, him being a possibility. You got Leo. Stephen Fulton dominated Angelo Leo earlier this year in January to take the title, so I don't see that fight happening. And then you got Ryosuke Iwasa, the former IBF champion. He lost, even though it was prematurely stopped, he lost to Murajan Akhmadaliyev earlier this year, so it's kind of a step-back opponent if he were to go that route. So for me, I really believe that an undisputed title fight can happen. I think it's just as likely, though, that Daniel Roman is Stephen Fulton's first opponent because he is the WBC and WBO number 1 contender. And then I also think Brandon Figueroa is still a possibility. So I think it's going to be one of those 3 fights. I really do. I don't think any other fights make sense more than those ones. Right now, I hate to say this, but I want to say, unless I hear more concrete evidence that Matchroom and the PBC are working together, I'm leaning towards Daniel Roman being Stephen Fulton's first opponent for the Unified Championship in a mandatory fight. But that doesn't mean that it's not possible. I think Akhmad Aliyev for the Undisputed title is the second most likely, and then I think Brandon Figueroa in a rematch is the third. But we'll see what happens. That's what's next for the Undefeated and Newly Unified Super Bantamweight Champion, Stephen Fulton Jr., following his career best win, 12-round majority decision over Brandon Figueroa. I hope you guys enjoyed this. True boxing, you've been here with the truth.